Well, actually, I represent the Department of Energy. I work for one of the national labs in the National Laboratories, DOE's National Laboratory System. It is the Department of Energy's role to develop, support the technology development for electric and hybrid vehicles, as well as smart grid. So we do a couple of things, and I have a role of integrating the automotive industry and utilities in this regard, what's called the vehicle grid interface, in a technical team called a grid interaction tech team that may be a little too odd for this interview, but in fact our job is to try to remove the barriers for vehicles plugging in to the grid. And the other role I have is international cooperation, specifically targeting cooperation on standards in the vehicle grid interface. Yes, well, the U.S. it's a very serious initiative to shift our transportation energy from petroleum to electricity. And basically what you have to do to get to that point is you have to have a supply chain that can supply batteries, motors, power electronics, and so forth. And you have to have an infrastructure that can handle the charging of those vehicles without greatly disrupting the grid. And the third issue is you have to have standards. And that is a very important point at the moment. So the program in the States decided to put their money where their mouth is, as we say, and we've invested about $7 billion in electric vehicle components and smart grid. That money has been matched by industry. So you're looking at a $15 billion investment over the past 2 years to improve electric vehicles and manufacturing to the point of being able to sell them and allow the grid to handle them in an effective manner. Well, in our case, we came into this administration with a very aggressive target of getting 1 million electric vehicles on the road by 2015. We, in fact, invested in the battery manufacturing industry to the point that we will have a 1 million unit capacity by 2015. And we have commitments from vehicle manufacturers to actually exceed that million vehicle mark by that time. Well, Germany is very important to us, obviously. We share manufacturers, we share suppliers. And the third element in making this all work between the manufacturing infrastructure, the electric infrastructure, the third is cooperation on standards. We have to have standards that are globally accepted, that our manufacturers and suppliers can live with. And so Germany is a key element in making this all work, because they sell vehicles globally, their suppliers are global in this area, and their suppliers span from the automotive industry to the electric industry. So this is a perfect match for us to work these issues together. The Transatlantic Economic Council was initiated by Germany and the U.S. over a decade ago, targeting transatlantic cooperation for the multinationals that work on both sides. So this is actually the perfect chance. We share an automobile industry, we share a supplier industry. So this situation is targeting standardizing componentry between the US and Europe to allow a multinational company like Mercedes or Siemens or General Electric to build components here that will definitely be applicable there. And it's the interesting thing about this is it's more than just the vehicle. We now plug into the wall. And behind the wall, we don't think about very often, but there's a whole business environment there that has to be established to deal with electric vehicles and to be able to handle the communication, the supply of electricity, and the billing, and so forth. We like to say that the green automotive industry will not work unless there is green at each of those nodes in the system.